Hey guys, it's Hef. I am back again, completely raw, because I can't be fagged to put makeup on, actually. And ironically, I'm going to be talking about makeup. So this is a collaboration with a whole bunch of other ladies from the Geeks and Beauties. This is your favourite shade in the palette. So in this, we go through like 10 to 20. I actually have 20, which is pretty much most of my palettes. And we talk about our favourite shade and swatch it, etc, etc. And yeah, so ironically, I have no eyeshadow on. I am just going to get into this. Some of these palettes that I have here are ones that I self-made, so you'd think that every shade is my favourite shade, but that's not really how it is. And these are not necessarily the shades that I use the most. For me, it's more like I look at the palette and that's the one my eye's drawn to. So that is how I'm going to approach this particular thing. And these palettes are all different sizes. Some of them are quite large, some of them are not so large. So I'm going to start with one of the smaller ones. This here is from a Chi Chi multi palette. There's like four or five of these around about the same size. They had a lip gloss in here. And as you can see, this one is mermaid-y. And my favourite shade in this palette is actually this one here. I mean, I love the purple. This one here. I picked this one out of all of these because this one is the only non-neutral. So that is it right there. Look at that. It's all pretty. So that is the one from there. It doesn't have a name. So if you're hoping for a name, it doesn't have a name. Chi Chi's a brand from New Zealand. The next one is the That's Heart palette from BH Cosmetics. This is the only BH Cosmetics palette I own. I got this from Monica the Diva. Won a giveaway. Yeah. And it looks like that. Can you see? I hit pan and my favourite colour. Can you guess which one it is? Actually, this one here. There may be some repetition here. It's purple is my favourite colour, but when it comes to eyeshadow, I'm always drawn to the kind of tealy type of shades. That's it right there. Very pretty. It actually goes on better on with a brush than it does with your finger, if I remember correctly. Not that I usually apply shadows with my fingers. I don't know, I just don't like it. Then we have the Comfort Zone palette. I haven't actually tried this palette. This is the old one, clearly. I got this one from Tamara in one of our swaps. But clearly, like most people, my favourite shade is this one here, because it is actually the most interesting. And if I'm not mistaken, it is a dupe for a shadow by MAC. I mean, Wet n Wild, Bargain Basement, but shit, I nailed it with that one. The shade is freaking phenomenal. It's like, it's just freaking amazing. So impressed. The other Wet n Wild palette, I haven't actually swatched this one yet. This one I got from Lena. Sorry, Lena. Brain. Not enough coffee. Okay, this is the Rosé in the Air. So this is one of the new ones. Old one, new one. They put an extra couple of shades in, like transition type shades. If I could get it open. That's because you're trying to open it the wrong way. Okay, so in this palette, the colour my eye is actually drawn to is actually colour I probably wouldn't use very much. It's actually this one right here. because I think it's actually really, really beautiful. I mean, the coppery one with shimmering around is pretty beautiful too, but that is an exceptional color. I don't swatch the best, but I reckon it goes on really well. Alright, that's that one. Now to go through some palettes that are probably not as well known to other people. So I have a bunch of LA Colors palettes here. In fact, one of my favourite palettes is an LA Colors palette. So the first one, this is one of their Color Spark ones. They're the ones with the duo. I'm taking a shitty sponge out. They have like... Again, so the... That was great. None of them are broken, so it's fine. But that's what it looks like. I think my favourite colour in this one is actually one of the single colours, this one here, green one. Yeah, this is pretty awesome. Oh, that's very nice. Yeah, I haven't used some of these palettes very much, clearly. Because, you know, when you have lots of palettes, you don't tend to use them. Oh, do you know what? That just snapped straight back in and is all stable again. There you go. That was good to know. And I have another one of those LA Color Spark ones. That first one was called Effect. Effect. This one is called Electric. And I'll just make sure... It's in properly. Oh dear. So this one is a pretty awesome. And I think my favorite is actually this one in the middle here. I mean, it's probably not that useful being two colors in one. But basically what you get is that, which is freaking gorgeous. Oh, that is beautiful. Should play with this more. It's a bit powdery, but it's a really, really cheap palette. Sorry. I clean up my finger there. Okay, another LA Colors one is this massive one. It's called Back to Basics. You might have actually seen this in a video when my daughter did my makeup. I'm pretty sure she used the shit out of this palette. They're all shimmery. There's like no like mattes or anything. But this color right here is my fave. Kind of greeny blue thing right up my alley. And the last LA Colors one is actually a smaller one. I've got eyeshadow all over my table at the moment. This one is one of these smaller palettes. I have a whole bunch of these ones. This one's called Brown Buzz. One of my favorite LA Colors ones is the neutral version of this, which is just like browns. In fact, I like it so much I have two of them, and I've used a whole of one shade in one of them. So this is what this one looks like. And my favourite colour is this colour. Yeah. See, I'm not predictable or anything. These ones are a bit harder to get my great long finger now, like my fingers with great long nails into, because they're quite small and deep. So that is that one right there. Very nice. Stops to get a face one. So I also have this palette. This is from W7. This you can get at Chemist Warehouse in Australia. It's actually an English brand. These are all shimmery shades. Probably haven't played with this one a lot. I think my favourite is actually this one here, because the purple and the teal are not very vibrant. I like more like pastel versions, but this is like it's a really nice coppery tone. Oh, that's really nice. I like it. I mean, clearly this is supposed to be ones that I like. And the last of the... actually, it's probably not the last of the brands that are unknown. Because I got a couple of random brands here. This one is from Absolute, which is an offshoot of Nika K. This is the Eclipse palette. It has some really gorgeous shades in it. They're not the best quality because, you know, it's meant to be a bargain basement type brand. But I think my favourite one is this one here. Because it is just so... It's unusual. It is different. I mean, it's gold, but it's still unusual. Because it's like... So... That's awesome. This has like really vibrant, and these two shades on the end, the black and the white, they are actually matte. And there is a couple of matte shades over here in the neutrals as well. So there's a couple of transition shades that are neutral. So it's not a bad like beginner type palette for someone who wants some colour, and it's got a whole bunch of neutrals in it. And it's got like black and white, so it's like, it's pretty good. Alright, so we have a Lacura palette. This is the Lacura Stepping Out palette. You probably saw me do a full face of makeup with this like Lacura. And that is what it looks like. Sorry, trying not to blind you with the mirror. Real pretty. I think my favorite shade in here would be this one here, because it's like a really unusual purpley gray shade. So that's it there. It doesn't swatch the best, but it's still really nice. But unfortunately, none of these are matte. They're all satin at best. So it's not like a complete palette or anything, even though there are 10 shades in there. Then I have a Models Prefer Shadows palette. This is the Day to Night Shadows. If you watched my pan out palette last year, you would have seen this, because I attempted to pan this palette, and I finished one shade. But my favourite shade is actually the shade Overachiever, which is this one right here. I quite liked this one too that I used up completely, but I can't swatch that for you. It's like this reddish brown shade. It's really nice. Of course, that is a dupe for one of the naked palettes. But you already knew that just by looking at it. Then, I'll do the last of the random brands that no one's probably ever heard of except for me and a few people in Australia. This is a makeup studio. I got this at a... makeup convention thing. These are not properly stuck in, so I've got to be like super duper careful. But this is like a self-made palette. Yeah, no, it's only got 5, but whatever. But my favourite is this one down here. These are baked eyeshadows. They do all have names, but I can't tell you what they are because they're not on them. But, right. I mean, clearly I like all of the shades because I picked them. But that one is my favourite to like look at. And then I have another self-made palette from another brand that I got at the same convention. This is Girly Cosmetics. It's a much bigger palette. It probably cost me the same to get this palette as it did to get the Makeup Studio one. That was the difference in price. Two of these are highlighter and a bronzer, which are these two shades down here. All the rest of them are eyeshadows, and they are freaking gorgeous. But I think my favourite... Oh, that's a hard pick because I love all of these so much. I think it's probably this dark green one here. I mean, I love the teal one that's next to it. That's, don't get me wrong, but super dark green is, and orange is, frankly, a stunning. This is It almost looks black on my skin tone. It's not. It's just super dark green. And it is gorgeous. Okay, we're almost there. Alright, let's do my Inglot palette. I have a little Inglot palette. I got this at the same convention. So, and Inglot palettes, you normally just buy the singles. But you can buy them in a... This is like the smaller size, one of the smaller sizes they do. My favourite is actually the one that looks really, really weird in here, which is the one on the end because I've swatched it a few times. It's actually three in one. It's like three colours in one and they're like pinky purple. And yes, you could probably use them individually, but I don't. I just swirl them all together because I'm a heathen like them. And it is so pretty. So pretty. And I like that their palettes are magnetic and the lids don't come off. Then we have my Sleek palette. You can pick up Sleek makeup at Target in Australia. This is the Eye Divine Storm palette, which does not want to open. Oish. Favourite one is this one here, which is called Electric Storm. This one here is Electric Storm. They all have names that are storm related, but they're on a stupid plastic sheet. Running out of space on my own because I swatched so badly. Crayon palettes here, one of which you've probably seen a lot on my channel because I'm currently panning it, and it's really dirty. This is the crayon palette that came with my makeup kit for beauty school. It had another side to it which was all cream products, which I got rid of, and as you can see there is that's a lot of shadows in this one. But my favourite shadow is actually a shadow I am currently attempting to put a hole in, and that is this stunning blue right here. It is so freaking gorgeous, and it is one of the better shadows in the palette. Not all of these shadows apply very well, but that one. It looks so freaking stunning. Often people will be like, oh, what colour are you wearing on your eyelids? Like, what's that blue? That's what the blue is, because it's fucking amazing. Excuse my language. And considering a lot of the crown shadows are kind of shit, it's great, but that is such a good one. This crown palette I won as a student of the year or assignment of the year or something. And it looks really, really gorgeous. It's got some blushes in it. It looks really, really gorgeous. But there's only one shadow that my eye is really drawn to because it is a very neutral palette. That is actually this shade right here. Which is kind of like a pinky purple shade. It is quite pretty. I found that most of the colours in here don't swatch worth a damn. That one's not too bad, but yeah. They're kind of shit, but hey, I got it for free. It's like a 30-something dollar palette in Australia. It's very much like the Morphe palettes. It's got the same kind of setup as the Morphe palettes, same kind of size. Morphe's probably... I don't know, I've never used a Morphe shadow, so I wouldn't know. But, and my last two palettes are both Lorac palettes. So this is the Lorac Pro. Got this from Tamara J. It was already well loved. I've just loved it some more. I think my favourite shade in here... I haven't played with this a lot. I've used some of them, but I haven't played with it a lot. But I think my favourite shadow, like the one I'm drawn to, is actually gold, which is... this one here. Which is actually ironic because of the number of people who had so much trouble working with this one. But... I happen to like gold, even though it's not always the best on my skin tone. Running out of space. So pretty. So pretty. And last but by no means least, the Lorac Mega Brew. This was the first high-end big palette that I ever bought. Actually, it's the only one that I ever really bought. Because they made it really hard to get the follow-on Lorocs, otherwise I probably would have bought them as well. This has not been used a lot. It has been used a little bit. I'm currently using Opal quite a bit. Shade's really interesting because it looks like it's just like a creamy white, but it's actually got a gold shift to it, which is really interesting. But my favourite shadow in here is actually Deep Teal, which is this dark green in the bottom corner. And running out of space. That's that one there. Super pretty. Yeah, so they are my 20 favourite shades from 20 of my palettes. This is an interesting palette right there. Somebody should make that palette. So that is it for this video, guys. If you want to, not if you want to, go and check everybody else out. Let them know that I sent you. They'll all be listed down below, as always. And the Geeks and Beauties group will be listed down below if I remember to put it in. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup related videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.